Another skill that we need to review before we jump into solving equations is in section 2.1.3, operations on polynomials. As a quick reminder, a polynomial is an expression composed of the sum of several terms where each term is the product of a coefficient and a power of x. So let's look at some examples of polynomials and classify them by the number of terms that they contain. For example, a monomial, the prefix mono goes with 1, might be something like 2x cubed. So this is a polynomial that contains one term, and we refer to it as a monomial. Now, it has more than one factor. One of the factors is 2, the other factor is x cubed, but together that is one term. So in our definition above, we're going to have the sum of several terms where each term is the product of a coefficient and a power of x. So the coefficient here is 2, and we have x to the third power. Now, in a binomial, we're going to have more than one term. So it may look something like x squared plus 3. I've got two separate terms. They're separated by the plus, and each term has a coefficient and a power of x. The first term has coefficient 1 with x to the power of 2. The second term has coefficient 3, and even though you don't see it there, we could think of it as x to the 0th power. A trinomial or a three-term polynomial may look like 5x squared plus 2x minus 7. Again, the terms are separated by plus or minus. Each term has a coefficient and a power of x. This is the type of expression that we're going to be working with here for a little while. Now, we want to review operations on polynomials. To add or subtract polynomials, our focus is basically combining like terms. Like terms have the same variable parts, even though their coefficients may be different. They're going to be like terms, for example, if they both have an x squared or they both have an x cubed. Now, when we subtract polynomials, we do have a preliminary step. We're going to be careful to use our distributive property before we combine like terms, and we'll do some examples of that. When we multiply polynomials, we're going to use an extended form of the distributive property. Specifically, when we multiply two binomials, we'll be using the FOIL process. So we're going to review all of that in these examples here. Example 3, perform the indicated operations and simplify completely. So in this example, we have a trinomial added to another trinomial, three terms each. Since we are adding these trinomials together, those parentheses really aren't doing anything important. So I can drop the parentheses and then look for like terms to combine. So here I have plus negative x cubed. I'm going to put that negative x cubed in parentheses just to separate those two signs. But it might be easier to view as simply minus x cubed. When you add a negative number, it's the same thing as subtracting. Now we're going to identify like terms. Remember, like terms have the same variable parts. So I've got a couple of terms that are x cubed terms. We've got a couple of terms that are x terms. And then I have a couple of terms that are constant terms. So I'm going to add like terms here. So 2x cubed minus x cubed gives us 1x cubed. Notice I just carry the variable parts and combine the coefficients. 2 minus 1 gives me 1. We have plus 5x minus 2x. That gives us plus 3x, and finally negative 7 plus 4, we end up with negative 3. So when we combine our two trinomials, we end up with another trinomial. Example B is a little different because this time we are subtracting polynomials. The first one in parentheses is a binomial, and the second one is a trinomial. Before we can combine like terms, we're going to distribute our negative. What that means is we're going to multiply each term in that second set of parentheses by a negative 1. The parentheses around the first term don't make a difference, so we can drop those. And when we distribute our negative, we have minus 5x squared minus 2x plus 8. Now we're going to combine like terms. Remember, like terms have the same variable parts. So we're going to combine the x squared terms. We're going to combine our constant terms. And then we have an x term that's all by itself. Negative 4x squared minus 5x squared gives me negative 9x squared. Now we want our polynomial in descending order. What that means is we want to go from the highest power of x to the lowest power of x. So the next appropriate term here would be that negative 2x term. Then we're going to add our constants. 1 plus 8 gives us 9. So that is the result of subtracting those two polynomials. So adding and subtracting involves combining like terms, and in the case of subtraction, also the use of the distributive property. Now we also want to review multiplying polynomials. When we multiply polynomials, we're going to be using the distributive property and FOIL. Now let's start with example D. It's a little less detailed, so we'll start with the easy one and then we'll backtrack to the hard one. 9x minus 1 squared. Now, when we see a binomial squared like this, it's really important that we do not distribute that exponent. Sometimes that feels like the natural thing to do, but that would lead us to a mistake. So when we see a binomial squared, we're going to multiply that binomial by itself twice, okay? When you see the product of two binomials, remember you use the FOIL process. F stands for first, O stands for outside, I stands for inside, and L stands for last. So it's just a way of remembering to multiply every term by every term. So I'm going to start by multiplying the first two terms in each spot. 9x times 9x gives me 81x squared. Then we're going to multiply our outside terms. The outside terms are in the outermost position of those binomials. So we're going to evaluate 9x times negative 1. That's going to give me negative 9x. Then we're going to multiply our inside terms, these two guys right here. Negative 1 times 9x gives me negative 9x. And finally, we'll multiply our last terms together. Negative 1 times negative 1 gives me positive 1. So first, outside, inside, and last. Now, when I apply that FOIL process, generally we're going to have some middle terms that are like terms. So we'll combine like terms and we'll have our product. 81x squared minus 18x plus 1. So make sure that you practice that FOIL process. Now back to the one that's a little more difficult. We have a binomial times a trinomial. That means two terms times one term. And we don't have a word like FOIL to remember this process. But the concept is to make sure that everything gets multiplied by everything. A systematic way of doing this so that you don't leave anything out is to take the first term of that binomial and distribute it to each term of the trinomial. And then, once that's complete, we'll distribute the second term. So let's get started. X times x squared gives me x cubed. Now remember, I can look over here. When we combine like terms, we keep the variable part and combine the coefficients, right? But when we multiply terms that contain powers of a variable, we add the exponents. So x to the first times x squared gives me x cubed. Continuing our distributive property here, x times 3x gives me 3x squared. And last, x times negative 10 gives me negative 10x. So the first term has been completely distributed. I can ignore that term now and focus on the second term. I'm going to also distribute that to each term of the trinomial. So 2 times x squared is 2x squared. 2 times 3x is 6x. and 2 times negative 10 is negative 20. So every term gets multiplied by every term. If you think about it as a couple of applications of the distributive property, then you will be sure to get everything multiplied by everything. But we're not quite done. We need to simplify by combining like terms. So I only have one x cubed term, and that's the highest power, so it's going to go first. Then we've got a couple of x squared terms to combine. 3x squared plus 2x squared gives us 5x squared. Then we have a couple of x terms. Negative 10x plus 6x gives us negative 4x. And finally, we have a constant term there on the end, negative 20. So this is a review of what a polynomial is, how to name polynomials, and how to add, subtract, and multiply polynomials. FOIL is extremely important, so make sure you practice that a lot. And the more you practice it, the better prepared you will be for factoring coming up in the next section.